About 5:30 in the morning, a very late, unproductive night, trying to catch up, and I'm gonna be spending a little bit of time with Alana this morning. Should be good. I know I don't seem way too excited about this morning, but just know this is. It may not seem like a lot, but trust me, this morning is very, very important. Main reason being that I am never awake when Alana's awake. I go to bed late, she wakes up late. We never have breakfast together. So we're having a little breakfast date so we can make some time for each other. Very important stuff. It's gonna be a good video. Editing went way longer than I thought it would. I'm in the
mood. Home haircut, everybody! What the heck? Welcome!
Oh my god. How do you feel that you're not gonna have to cook supper by yourself this morning? Evening?
Why not?
Because I'll be cooking it with you.
Why?
Because we're making brunch.
I'm in the mood for love. Simply because you're near me. Honey.
Oh, I got shell in there.
I'm gonna expose you.
Dethrone you.
Exposed. It's gonna make some people real hungry. Okay, so time that we have a talk. I've been called a bum, a loser, but it's okay. Let me tell you why. The main thing I think everyone has to realize is that it's all a part of growing and becoming the person that you're gonna be. And I'm just in those stages right now. Forgive the mess in the background. Still haven't been able to do everything that we've been working on. It's not done yet. The difference between being a loser and reaching your dreams. If you want to reach your dreams, it's very likely you're gonna be a loser at some point. I don't think that just because you aren't anything special yet that you won't be. Three main things that I need in my life. I need to work on my cars. That's my number one thing. Number two, I need to work for myself or with friends. And number three, I need to race, drift, and have fun filming and making stories. And even though I know all of that right now, there's two reasons why I'm a loser. Number one, I am a nobody who is trying to be somebody. No one cares about my life. Maybe you guys do. You guys are seeing this obviously on my channel. You guys, maybe. But if you show my clips, my videos, to anyone that you know, they will look at it, maybe say, oh, that's nice, and then they're out. And it's fine, because if everyone cared, the world would actually be a lot better of a place. No, it's just unrealistic. Everyone starts out as a nobody. I don't care who you are. At some point, no one knew who you were. On the other hand, there's one more thing that realistically you should know. I know what I want to do because I've tried tons of different jobs, I think. You can disagree if you want. I've done essentially what you could consider just kind of like in a corporation where you're working to kind of help a storefront or some organization or something move forward. and that's where your contribution to society goes. And then the one that I prefer the most, you know, just one sec. You put on one of these, you go to work and you build houses or facilities that tons of people are gonna use daily. Maybe they're gonna live out of, maybe they're gonna work out of, but you build society. You help society move forward. You help an organization move forward. I know out of those two, which I prefer, but I've always shown characteristics that I am not meant for either of those two categories. There's kind of like a third category, and this ominous, mystical third party that I'm referring to is moving yourself forward. Through school, through work, I've always shown that I exceed in pushing what I'm allowed to do. I don't do well with having a cap. If someone says, I want you to move 5 boxes into that pile, as a very simple example, I will move 15 boxes into said pile. If someone says, design this, and it's a very simplistic thing, they say, make some text, and I did this in high school, instead of just making a typography, I will make a full text that provides a story to it. It's kind of complicated, but like, I always push boundaries. I always continue to do more than I should, and I get in shit for it every job I've ever had. It's super frustrating. I've had it happen for years, and I try to just do my job, and I can't do it. I always end up doing more, and it has never worked out in a positive fashion. Either my employers wanted me to be stupid, my employers didn't want me wasting time doing more than I had to, just tons of issues. Okay, so am I a loser? Yes. Sadly, yes. But I'm a loser for the right reasons. And it's not a bad thing, because everyone at some point, if they're doing something worth doing, is gonna be a loser. So I am here, standing in front of you, lovely people, saying that I am a loser because I have not achieved any kind of notable success as far as this goes. My what I'm trying to be job. And it's not to be negative or anything, it's just I haven't made it yet. It is what it is. You can't force that to happen. You need to earn it. The difference between being a loser and being someone who achieves their dreams is that you are not willing to quit. And whether you are there today, tomorrow, or never, you will continue to pursue that dream so that one day, maybe, you get to live the life that you want. I wish you all the best. That's the thing about success. You don't know until you know that you have it, but you'll never achieve it unless you keep pushing for it. So don't give up. Keep doing what you're doing. I hope you guys appreciate the honesty. Stay safe out there and have a good one.
I'm making brunch.
we are making brunch.
This is so weird. You never help me cook.
I know.
You're not cooking dinner with her unless you get your hair cut.
Do we have to?
Yes.
Can we do it later?
Sit down.
She hates my hair.
I'm going to feed you chloroform and then I'm going to cut
your hair. I'm going to feed you chloroform. You just have to put it over his mouth. You don't have to give it to him.
I'm going
to
shove it down your throat.